As I sat in me window last Christmas, a letterman brought it to me. A little gilt-edged invitation saying, "Gilhooly, come over to tea." I knew that the Fogarty sent it, so I went just for old friendship's sake. I knew the first thing they'd feed me was a piece of Miss Fogarty's cake. There were pints of plums and cherries, with some lemon raisins and cinnamon.
Murphy came in with a saw. That cake had been baked with such powers for to paralyze any man's jaw. There were plums and prunes and cherries, there were citrons and raisins and cinnamon too. There were nutmeg cloves and berries, and it was always yellow and blue. There were caraway seeds in abundance.
Smiling and blinking away, cause she tripped over Flanagan's work boots and she dropped her for the other day. "Gilhooly," she said, "you're not eating. Try a little bit more for me, say." "Oh no, Mrs. Fogarty," says I, "for a half pint of your cake."
There were plums and prunes and cherries, there were citrons and raisins and cinnamon, there were nutmeg cloves and berries.
When they throw in the mice.
Oh, Miss Fogarty.